Hi guys, in today's video we are going to see how we can add a button to the constant layout and add a click event to it. So this is the application which I have created in my last video, where we have created a main activity from the scratch. So in this video we will see like how to add a button. So for button you need to go to the palette and you will find buttons in here, and here you can see different types of buttons. So we will be using very basic one. Let me just enlarge the view. And when you drag the button on your layout, so maybe in center, so what you need to do for the constraint layout, you need to add the constraints for this. So like, if you don't want to get into much details, you can just click on this magic wand tool, which is info constant. So what it will do is it will just see where your button is, and it will add constraint for like from the top, from left, from right. So let me just click on it, and you can see it added a constraint from left and from the top. You can also see the same things. 74 is from left and 24, and you can also drag this, and it will increase and decrease according to the dragging position of your button. So we can change the ID of this as well. So let me just change the ID, and it will just change the ID for it. And let's drag one more thing so that we can see whether the button is clicked or not. We will go with the text and the text view. It's like a label. So let me just drag this in here. And now when you click on this insert constant point, you will see a bunch of arrows of this. So what it will do is it will create a reference for this button, and it will track this and place himself on the layout. So that is some basic things for you to get started. So when you click on it, you can apply a click event on it. So either you can scroll through from here, or you can just search your desired property. So I will just search for click, and this will show it like that. So I can just add something like button one hyphen click. You can add any function name on it. So sorry. So it will be there. So if you have worked with ASP.NET, if you double click it, it will create a click event, but in the Android Studio it will not. So as you can see, it's already gone. So before adding it in here, let's just add it inside our main activity so that our UI will understand. So for button click, we need to make it as public, and there is no return type for that. And let's just add this click, and the parameter of this will be view. So whenever it will get entered, we will have some information regarding the button. So let me just click on the Alt Enter on it to import the class. And I will just place it complete the function, and inside that I will just use my snippet from this in order to save the time. So from the view we can identify which button is being clicked, so we can reuse the same click button. So when you do that, it should show this button one. So whenever it has been clicked, it will just check on it, and then we can do some stuff over this. So let's just see whether the brackets are completed. I think yeah, we are good now. And then in order to replace the text, like when I click on it, I will just replace the text view text. So for that we have another function or a snippet, you can say. This is the snippet. What it is doing is it's using find view ID. So it's more like a JavaScript thing, get document by ID kind of thing. And we are passing the text view ID. So ID, you can find ID is in here. So if you go to the code, you will find the ID in here. Similarly, you will find a button ID in here. And it is showing button click in here as well. So we will just come back later. So for now, let's just use this ID. And I'm using Control Tab to get to my last editing location, or last use tab actually. So this is a text view. ID is fine, and message text view. So we need to type cast it, because it will come as an object. So in order to type cast in the text view, we need to cast it like that, and then we can set text. This is a function which will set the text, right? So I think everything is done, and the only thing is pending is adding the click event on it. So click event will be added from the UI. So let's click on this active main and go to I need to double click on it, and either you can place it in here, or you can again go to the design and choose here. So I think we are good to go. What will happen is when we click on the button, it will change the text from here. So let me just run this app and show you the emulator. One cool thing which I like about this emulator is you can run it only once, and it can be used for different application you have, like debugging and all. So whenever you click on a run, so it will take the most recent application which is clicked by it. So it will show it in here. So let's just click on it, and as you can see, the button text is changed. So that is how you can add a click event and add a label to your constant view, and do stumps according to it. So I hope you like the video, and I will try to make it as simple as possible, so that we don't have to go into so many details. So if you like the video, please subscribe and share, and if you have any questions, please comment below. I will try to answer them as quick as possible. So thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.